सपना तो कहीं भी देख सकते हैं, फिर समंदर क्यों?
वह सपनों की सीमा नहीं रहती।
कैसा दिया?
100 रुपए के 10।
संभल के सलीम, समझते हो ना हम क्यों कह रहे हैं?
हेलो तारा, who is this young lady with you?
It's Miss D'Souza. I wish to hear nothing except English in your English class.
दीदी, इसने बिल्ली को बचाया, मैंने इसको बचाया। ये भी हीरो, मैं भी हीरो।
छोकरी से दूर रहने का तेरे लिए नहीं है।
Hi everybody, this is Gitanjali Rao. I am the director of Bombay Rose, and I'm very happy to be here at the CTN Expo in order to share the making of Bombay Rose, which is a 2D animated film from India. Bombay Rose is painted frame by frame, and it's probably the first Indian animation film to have been the opening film at the Venice Film Festival. And the film has been doing a lot of festivals. And of course, because of the pandemic and the lockdown, we are here sharing our experience of making Bombay Rose virtually with whoever is interested. So thank you all for being here and watching our making of. And it's a pity that we cannot be there in person and meet each other as would have been possible in a normal year. However, animation is something that I feel it touches hearts of people all over the world, and even without an interaction, without networking, it is something that can reach across continents, across countries, across people of different faiths, religions, different localities, different geographies, simply by the universal truth of it being a piece of art. And Bombay Rose especially is out and out a very, very artistic film. I would say artistic because it's actually painted frame by frame, and it's painted in the way I paint my animation films. I have a very personal, organic style of painting my films, and usually such a kind of technique is reserved for short films. But I think I got really ambitious, and I had a bunch of people, friends, people who supported me, who pushed me to make a feature film using the same organic painted frame by frame style. And I think Bombay Rose is unique because we managed to, in a film of the length of 94 minutes, we managed to keep the organic feel, the painted feel in today's world, and create a story which also has a very organic and personal feel. So what I would like to talk about today is my journey of how the idea came to me, how I made the film, and essentially the team that supported, the artistic team that we put together to make the film. So Bombay Rose is a story about two young people falling in love, which would have been a normal story, except this is based on the streets of Bombay. The two people live in the streets of Bombay, like a lot of people do. The girl is Hindu, the boy is Muslim, and they fall in love. And in a place like India, it is a taboo. It has become more of a taboo now with the right-wing politics that is wrenching us apart. And it's very, very relevant to a lot of countries where tolerance is a big issue. religious tolerance. And I think my films and my stories are not merely something that I would say or use to entertain people. Yes, of course, I want to entertain people. But along with the entertainment, I want people to feel, to think, to question, to especially the young audience who is grappling with a very new post-truth that exists. I want them to understand that a film is not just, especially an animation film like Bombay Rose, it's not just a children's film with a lot of funny gags and a lot of fun that you have and then you forget the film. It is a mature film which works for children, which works from the ages of 8 to 80, as we would love to say it. It works for children, it works for the youth, it works for old people, it works for people who are Muslim, it works for people who are Hindu, it works for people who are Christians. It works for just about everybody. Simply going by the fact that it has a universal truth of love and peace. So Bombay Rose is a story about a Hindu girl falling in love with a Muslim boy. Both of them live on the streets of Bombay, which in itself is a story of survival. So Bombay Rose is made more like a documentary film in animation. My stories, I love to tell stories which of things which actually happen. And I use the medium of animation to not necessarily go into impossible things or fantasies or science fiction. My reason to use animation is because through animation, I love to get into the psyche of a person, into the psychology of the mind, into what a person is thinking, is dreaming, is imagining, is fantasizing. And these fantasies, these imaginations come to life through animation, and they are impossible to create in live action. So I would love to take you through the making of Bombay Rose, through the process of let me tell you for a fact, Bombay Rose was made in a very, very unconventional way. Unconventional in a lot of ways. I live in a country like India where we have absolutely no financial support from the government or to make animation films. Neither is the private sector very interested in making films which are not solely for children, which are not hero-driven, which are not commercially driven. And films which have a social message like mine. So right from the beginning, I was thinking of and wanting to make a story which is very, very unconventional in a place like India with no financial support, more or less. So what I did was start writing the script, and over a period of time, because of the short films that I've made, it became easier and easier for me to make this film. What I would like to do is, as I said, it's a very unconventional film. So it was made in a very unconventional way. It was made in a very small studio in Bombay called Paperboat Animation Studio, which should not be underestimated at all because of the fact that it is small. It is small. We had a very small budget, but it is full of a place which is full of incredible ideas, very clever people, very smart people. We have always in Paperboat Animation worked with very few resources and therefore used our smartness, our intelligence, a lot of cleverness to make some impossible things to complete the film. So what you will see in the film is actually something which I feel no one else attempts in animation. And we attempted that. I think we were quite audacious, we were quite ambitious, we attempted a lot of things which are not usually attempted in animation. And the fact that we are here today just proves that I think we succeeded. So let me take you back a little back in time in 2019 when we made the film, and the bunch of people that worked on the film and explained to you some in some ways how we resolved the issue of taking an artistic animator's single vision and style and to make it into a full-length feature film.
After having made True Love Story, there was French interest in my film. La Film DC had approached me a year earlier, interested in my work, and they were interested in producing my next feature. But they could come in only as a French partner. And that is where sending the script to NFDC, it being talked about, a lot of people from France and come to Film Bazaar. So I presented the pitch of the film and Sinistan was there.
And we watched Gitanjali's previous shorts, True Love Story and Printed Rainbow, and fell in love with her voice and vision. She's an incredibly singular filmmaker. And we came on board as co-producers with significant finance to make this film.
There was an offer to animate the film abroad. But my problem was, it's only Indians who know how Indians walk, talk, behave, and the landscape without having this, you know, touristic eye to it. So my style more or less was to almost make a documentary film kind of a thing with animated characters. The look is real, the people are real, the clothes they wear is real, the things they do is real, the way they speak is absolutely real. Where I get into unreality and the fantasy element is in the dreamscape, is in their hopes, in their aspirations. And those dreamscapes are impossible to make in live action. So in the film, there are lots of times where just to counter the reality, people either get into their own dreams, their own memories, or they watch a Bollywood film and their own interpretations. So these become the different styles. Actually, Paper Boat was in my mind even before I got greenlit by the producers. Simply because in animation, you know just about everybody who's doing what kind of animation. And over the years, I chose not to join studios and get into a lot of places because they were doing outsource work and they were not doing their own content. So for me to be able to find a team of artists who can do my kind of animation, which is not just 2D animation, it's painted frame by frame 2D animation. It's like the most difficult thing you can ever choose to do.
So we actually spent three, four months after hiring of entire team. We actually trained all these people under Gitanjali, of course.
I eventually do something called a casting. Whether it is in line drawing, whether it is in shadows or color, there are people who are good with a certain character, very, very good, and not so good with another character.
It was very important for us to get the entire team on board, which is thinking similarly.
So we had a smaller bunch of animators, a smaller bunch of paint artists, and we started training them in the style that I was creating.
First 3-4 months, at that time, we actually struggled a lot with the style. We didn't find artists who were able to adapt to our style. So we had to actually replace some artists. So it took us actually 6 months to actually have that, to have the 100% fit team.
So the first 3 months was spent in that while I was storyboarding the entire film. We started doing the pre-production. Pre-production means designing the characters, developing them, showing them how they will look in each and every emotion. The principal characters, the subordinate characters, all of them are designed. And again, because it's my style and all, this is something I did by myself. A normal way of doing things is you go in for dubbing the voices and you also shoot actors playing the parts. So the second part I skipped and I didn't want to do that.
Sirf meri.
Then you have the character and you have the voices, and you start briefing the animators on line drawing animation.
To try and understand her vision, you know, that's extremely important for us and our entire team. What is she trying to do here, you know? So to be able to work with 60 to 80 people and still make the film independent, to make every frame as if it's her frame. It's not a studio thing, you know, it is her frame. It was actually important for us to make the film look as if it's her film.
So what I do as a process is completely paint the animation and composite it myself. So it was broken down to somebody who's an expert in line drawing animation will do the line drawing animation, and we will train people to color the animation on Photoshop frame by frame. And as we started doing the process, we also realized we need somebody in between who will do the shadows. And it was too much work for the animators, and it was ununderstood to the coloring artists because they were not animators. So it was to devise a combination of somebody who can draw well, somebody who understands shadows, and a third person who can color well, to make it all come together to look like one colored frame that I would do. Final stage is compositing, where all these things are put together in terms of the visuals and the sound design. For me, the most creative partners is the sound designer of my film, because it's animation, it comes silent.
This is the most challenging work that we have ever done till date, because Bombay Rose has per se very ordinary sounds which we call noises in Bombay. Everything is noisy in here. And the characters who are supposed to be by the Juhu Beach or by the roadside selling flowers, the atmospheric sounds are what Bombayites consider noise. So we have to create a soundscape just out of noise, literally. And of course, they are very characteristic sounds if you really pay attention to it. And building something with these elements for us, it was really challenging. But we've been having a lot of discussion before, and so we are pretty aware of the film and the soundtrack. If you ask in what way this film is different, in this film, in Bombay Rose, the sounds are very, very ordinary. You know, they are traffic noises of Bombay and very many details of Bombay, but they are not like really impeccably clean, nice sounding stuff, you know. So the design aspect is not about its cleanliness, or, you know, it's like surprising people with nice, sweet sounds or nothing of that sort. And about the dream space and the reality, that's another game we had to play, and the picture, strong picture support is there. So we try and played around reverberating very many small things, and try to create a magical space, and then transition to the dreamy world is something we have worked very elaborately, and a little bit of music track also helped achieving that.
So what the sound designer brings in to interpret the animation the way it is, and what the coloring person brings in, the color scripting person brings in, which is, as you'll see the film, it is color scripted very, very beautifully, like a painting.
We have a lot of fights on the floors, we have arguments, but at the end of the day, everybody is extremely happy with the film. So what actually counts is that people need to be People need to feel ownership about the film. You know, it's every artist has to feel that it's his or her film.
The layers of the 2D hand-painted animation becomes more extraordinary. It's built up frame by frame, and if you notice the backdrops of the palm stall or where Kamala lives or beach or the dancing bar or when you go into the fantasies, each is like a painting that could be in the National Gallery. And then on top of that, you layer this extraordinary story of love, romance, of a changing, evolving Bombay, of lost love, of poverty, and the whole juxtaposition gives an extraordinary insight in what it is to live in Bombay today, and it is stunning, and it has been a real joy to watch it grow.
So that is the story of how we made Bombay Rose, and it was quite an experience. 2 years of blood, sweat, tears, fights, a lot of love, a lot of hard work, a lot of people putting in every part of their brains, a lot of their lives that they put into the film to make it happen. And finally, when the film happened and when it was selected in Venice as the opening film, it was a great feeling because, as I said, not a single Indian animation film has made it. And not a lot of people believed that we could make a film, we could make a film to this quality, but we did. And it came out and it went to a lot of festivals and a lot of people loved the film. And that for me is very, very important. The takeaway of the audience, which I feel is a strength of the film, is that they understand a little more about what it means to live on the streets of Bombay. Not just live on the streets and survive, which is a very, very difficult part, but even in all that difficulties, to fall in love and to try and negotiate love. To try and negotiate love, even if love is not a success. And then to go beyond that and survive the loss of love. I think that is very common as an incident that happens to a lot of people all over the world, especially in not so rich countries. And I just feel that these are stories of survival which need a canvas, which need a film to be told. These are not stories of heroes. These are not stories of superheroes. These are just stories of common people. But they're very brilliant stories. They're very rich stories. They're stories of people who actually overcome realities in life and therefore become a hero because they survive it. Bombay Rose is a film about survival. It's about dealing with loss. It's about dealing with difficulties through love and wishing for peace, not through violence and not the easy way out. The more difficult way out, which will eventually lead to peace. And I think that is the need of the hour for us to understand that violence is not a solution to intolerance. Intolerance is something we face more and more and more every day, all of us living in various places of this world, religious intolerance especially. And that is not something that can be dealt with violence. That is only something that can be dealt with awareness and peace and love and sensitivity. And I think Bombay Rose sensitizes people to understand all these things. I wish it does. And I hope that when people watch the film, this feeling which we all worked ourselves for 2 years, labored over, will come across to any and everyone who watches the film. It is a pleasure being here, and thank you very much from everybody from the Bombay Rose team.